Hi, I'm Sonia Heinman, and my project was on distraction, how distraction happens and when it happens the most. I was doing my project on distraction because I was really intrigued on why distraction happened the most, and I really wanted to figure out how to stop distraction in its tracks, so that way we could keep on track of how we could do our homework and stuff, so that way we can get farther in school. And I just thought that maybe there was really a way to stop distraction instead of just thinking that there's no way to stop it. On my experiment, I tested my entire family, my stepdad, and I was testing this to test the different ages to see what they were distracted by the most and when they were distracted the most. I tested my stepdad, who was 31, my mom, who was 30, my older sister, who was 12, and my little sister, who was 5. I used a series of different questions and an average of 5 questions with each person. And my first test that I used to ask them, I asked them a whole bunch of different questions in a solitude room with nothing in it, no different noises or loud noises or shouting or other people, except for me and the person I was testing. And then the second test, I mixed up the questions, and then I asked the same questions, but in a different order and using a bunch of different distractions. We were in the living room for that test, so we could use the TV and our computer to our advantages with loud noises, dropping stuff in other rooms. We were playing stuff on my iPad. We had other people in the room talking. And actually, for one of my second tests, we had my grandmother over, so that helped a lot to have another person in our room. I also had a theory on when and where distraction happened. I actually got this, I got a little bit of the information online, and I got that when we wake up in the morning, we have a certain amount of energy, and once we go to bed, we get rid of that energy, and by the end of the day, we don't have as much energy. But since some people say that we only use 10% of our energy in our brains, I thought of this, and then I thought, well, what if we've gotten used to using that much amount of energy, and then if we use a little more than 10%, we'll be extra stressed out and distracted at the end of the day instead of calm and peaceful and knowing. This also answered one of my other questions that wasn't really related to this project, but it was, why do we have school in the beginning of the day? But that's also because we are more on focus. Whenever I did my test, I looked up more different myths of the brain, and I figured out that a lot of people actually believe that the reason why distraction happens is because of the different genders, which I believe that this is different than this is mostly a myth. I also believe that you can also, it's also because of how much, if you skip your breakfast, you'll be less on focus, and if you don't get a lot of sleep, you'll be less on focus. I've also figured out that different areas of the brain take different amounts of energy. So if you're doing a lot of decision making and stuff, then it'll take up a lot of energy. As we go through the day, we will use this energy in the different areas of the brain, like in the primary somatic, sensory cortex, motor cortex, movement, intelligent, and personality, hearing, sight, and touch. And these different places use different amounts of energy, and I found out that the intelligence and personality, which is in the front of the brain, uses a lot more energy which surprised me. The cerebellum doesn't use as much energy as the intelligence and personality, because the intelligence and personality is what we're using all day to keep up a good mood and to be able to write things and read things and stuff. And this surprised me because the cerebellum is larger than the intelligence and personality. In fact, I read online about 50% larger, but it still uses about 85% less in amount of energy than the intelligent personality. What also surprised me was the hearing part. Since we hear a lot of stuff, and we can just zip through and hear stuff so quickly that we use more energy in hearing than we use in the cerebellum, which is in the back of the brain, which helps us develop colors and different stuff, which surprised me a lot because you see a lot of colors. And since hearing and intelligence and personality take up so much energy, it helps in that being distracted in the other parts, like in sight and touch and movement area. And so it just makes you get feel like you're more tired, but actually it's because you're less on focus in those areas because you don't have as much energy. And I also thought that this worked out the same way that your entire body like coheres, because if you use a lot of energy in one part of the body, then the rest part of the bodies will feel really terrible. So I thought, what would happen if you tried to distract somebody with something else besides noises and people? What if you tried to distract them with like tricks of the mind, playing tricks like people say, playing tricks on your eyes? So I thought, what would happen if we use different like eye teasers that you use where you're like trying to look at it? And we tested that. We like used different things like tricks and stuff, and that actually distracted people a lot more because it made them strain and it made their head hurt. Also, if you do something out of the ordinary that you wouldn't do every day because your mind is so set, you know what you're gonna do every day, you do your regular things every day. And if you do something out of the ordinary, then actually it will take a whole lot more energy than if you did something regularly. Like if you take a jog every day, your brain will get used to that. Or if you do a whole bunch of math questions every day, your brain will get used to that. But then maybe the next day you have to write a 50-page report. That'll make your brain get off a little bit because it's not really used to doing stuff like that. And I also found that whenever you're older, the older you are, if you're in an age range to 0 to 10 years old, you're distracted more. Well, you're not really distracted as much. You're distracted more by noises and pictures and different colors and people. But if you're in the range of 11 to 45, you're distracted more by other, like, people yelling at you. You're distracted more about assignments, reminders, you're distracted more of electronics, and you're definitely distracted more of loud noises coming from other rooms because you feel that you need to see what happened and you feel that you need to help them, and that's keeping you from what you were actually doing. And I found that different questions, like my little sister, it took her tremendously more time and all of the questions that I asked her because she was distracted way more. Only one question did she answer that was really, like, quickly, was who her best friend was. But my stepdad, he could answer stuff in, like, he can answer questions in 1.26 seconds. It was amazing how fast he could answer them, even with all the distractions running around him. And I also found a lot of different facts about the brain, and one of the best ways that I figured out to prevent distraction, this is my theory, is to getting good night's sleeps, like full 8 to 9 hours of sleep, and eating a good breakfast every morning. And I've we actually did an experiment on that too, where one night we had my little sister up until midnight. This was on a weekend we did this. And the next morning, she couldn't really do anything. She didn't even want to really eat breakfast. But then the next night, we had her go to bed earlier, maybe around 8 o'clock. And then the next morning, she woke up and she was ready to do everything. She was on task. She was coloring a lot. She was drawing a lot of pictures. She was really focused on what she was doing. And that's what I thought, that because of the energy in your brain also inherits from whenever you're sleeping. So that's why you need to get a good night's sleep and a good breakfast to help you get, like, keep from getting distracted. And that's really it.